Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's ask the question, does it help to update your AdMob libraries? Okay, last Friday night on the live stream, we talked about a bunch of topics. We went from GDPR to running your own business to AdMob revenue. We talked about loads of different things, and we'll probably do all that on the next live stream if you can join us. But one of the things I mentioned in that live stream was that I need to update my AdMob SDKs, and maybe that will help my RPMs a little bit because my revenue has fallen a lot since last year, but I'm waiting for the GDPR stuff to play out so I know when to update it, right? So. And I had a question the following day from Hitchum Raff, who said, "Hi Eric, yesterday you said that you're having a low RPM, maybe because your AdMob SDK is old. Is that true? Because I have like version 9 of the SDK and my RPM is like really low, almost nothing. Nice videos, salutations from Morocco." Hey Morocco, cool. So just to be clear, I don't know if that's gonna make a difference, right? I'm gonna update my SDKs just because I need to do that every so often and it's been a few months since I've done it. And my suspicion is that it will have some effect, although it might not. It's probably not gonna bounce me back to where I am. I know the reason that my RPMs is low is mainly because of the target locations. The majority of my users are coming from, at the moment, there's still, the majority is still coming from the US, but a substantial portion is coming from India, and those RPMs are a bit lower. So I still have the impressions, which is the only thing that I really have any control over, right? But so all that's good, but the revenue is low. So I still have hope, I still have faith, and my suspicion is that updating the SDKs is gonna help eventually anyway, because you have to think about from AdMob's point of view or from Google's point of view, they have a certain amount of inventory that they send out, and they always want you to update SDKs, get the latest security enhancements and everything like that. So I do try to make sure that I update every so often. And sometimes you can actually do that. Like some of our apps are in Corona, it gets compiled with them, and I don't know which versions of the SDK they even use with their plugins and everything like that. But, you know, and something I have to keep updating is, it could be a hassle, especially with that. And it's one of the benefits of actually removing all the free versions from the Apple side of things is that I don't have to worry about that anymore, changing that. So what I'm gonna do is wait the next couple weeks until the May 25th, that's the deadline for GDPR. And we talked a lot about that the other night, and I have no answers. I know nothing, right? I've read the articles, I've read, you know, some people say, you have some people who say, it's just like Y2K, it's a big nothing, everyone's stressing about nothing. And on the other side, you got people who say, hey, we need to get set up our own server and our own database and get consent from users to serve them ads and all this kind of stuff. And I haven't seen anybody show me any implementation or, hey, this is specifically what you want to do. And I think it's because nobody really knows. But just to be clear on that, Hitchum, I don't know if it's going to help, but I would like to ask the rest of you guys, have you ever updated your SDKs for AdMob and seeing a boost in your RPMs? Because I'd be really interested in that. For me, it's just a suspicion, right? There's only so much data that we can see in terms of what quality of ads we get and what else is available out there on the inventory. So we don't know if we get good ads to our apps or bad apps or bad ads. So so I'd be really interested in what you guys have to say. Anyway, thanks very much for showing up to the live stream last week, Hitchum, and watching that. And that's it for today. Talk to you guys tomorrow.